Let me tell you a story. One chilly morning in Kiambu, Mama Njoki, a smallholder farmer with just 150 broilers, called me in a panic. Her birds were only 3 weeks old, but some were panting, others had pasty droppings, and their growth was patchy. She'd already spent over $140 on feed, but the weight gain wasn't matching. That's when I asked her a simple question. "Do you have baking soda in your kitchen?" She laughed. "You mean the thing I use to soften beans?" "Yes. That very same sodium bicarbonate." Fast forward 7 days, and those dull, stunted broilers were alert, active, and gaining weight like crazy. Mortality dropped to zero, and the smell in her coop cut in half. Baking soda, less than $1 a packet. Yet it corrected hidden acidosis, improved digestion, and supercharged growth. Now let me ask you, how many farmers are losing thousands of dollars every cycle just because they didn't know about this one kitchen secret? This video could save your next flock and your profits. So if you care about healthier chickens and better returns, give this video a like, share it with a fellow farmer, subscribe so you don't miss science-backed tips like this, and let me know in the comments where you're watching from. Kenya, Nigeria, Philippines, Uganda, South Africa. I'd love to hear from you. Let's dive in. Broiler farming can feel like a gamble. You buy expensive feed, vaccinate religiously, and follow all the right protocols. But somehow, some batches grow unevenly. You see birds lagging behind. Flocks that should reach 2.5 kilo at 5 weeks only hit 1.8. Or worse, some birds die suddenly after feeding, wings spread, eyes wide open. Sound familiar? You might think it's Newcastle or Gomboro, but sometimes it's not even a disease. It's something more silent, metabolic acidosis. Here's what many farmers don't realize. Broilers grow fast, almost unnaturally fast. In just 42 days, they balloon from 40 grams to over 2.5 kilos. That's like a child growing to adulthood in 6 weeks. This rapid growth creates intense pressure on their metabolism. Their bodies produce acid during digestion, and if this acid isn't neutralized, the bird becomes sluggish, digestion suffers, immunity drops, and growth stalls. You can have a perfect vaccination schedule and still lose money if your bird's internal pH is off. And this is where baking soda, yes, sodium bicarbonate, becomes your silent weapon. Think about it this way. When you chew sugarcane and your stomach feels funny, what do you reach for? Malox? Eno? These are antacids. They neutralize excess stomach acid. Chickens don't have a choice. Their bodies rely on internal buffers, like bicarbonate, to keep things in balance. But under heat stress, poor water quality, or high-protein diets, that balance can collapse. Let's get into the science for a moment. Sodium bicarbonate is a natural buffer. It helps regulate pH levels in the bird's blood and digestive system. When added in small amounts to water or feed, it reduces acidity, improves feed conversion, supports enzyme function, and improves water intake. According to a 2019 study in the Journal of Poultry Science and Biotechnology, adding 0.2 to 0.5% sodium bicarbonate to the feed significantly improved body weight gain and feed efficiency in broilers under heat stress conditions. Another trial published by the University of Arkansas Extension found that bicarbonate inclusion helped maintain blood electrolyte balance, especially in fast-growing birds raised in hot environments, like we have here in Kenya and much of Africa. But here's the beautiful part. It's not just for hot seasons. Even during cold months, when farmers often overfeed protein, the resulting metabolic overload can cause subclinical acidosis. Birds drink less, pass watery droppings, and stop gaining weight. Baking soda helps restore that balance. I've seen this countless times. At a semi-commercial farm in Kitale, a farmer named Paul had 2,000 broilers. At week 4, he noticed uneven growth. 25% of his flock was significantly behind. I recommended a simple mix, 1 gram of baking soda per liter of water for 3 days. That's it, no antibiotics, no vaccines, just baking soda. Within 5 days, the smaller birds caught up. His average flock weight jumped from 1.6 to 2.1 kilos by week 5. And here's the kicker, he saved over $30 by skipping unnecessary antibiotics. Now let's break it down practically. If you want to try this, here's exactly how to do it safely.
Hi there, my name's Peter, and I've been raising chickens for over 10 years now. Layers, broilers, even some indigenous birds. Let me be honest, before I found this book, I was struggling. Feed prices were going up, antibiotics were becoming less effective, and my flock just wasn't performing like it used to. Then I came across The Organic Chicken Farmer's Guide by Dominic Ngafo and Mugweru Isaac. I decided to buy it, and I'll tell you something. It changed everything on my farm. This guide isn't theory, it's practical. It shows you how to use local, affordable things like garlic, neem, turmeric, aloe vera, even charcoal, to keep your birds healthy and productive. I started small. I tried the moringa and garlic in the water for a week. I noticed improved appetite, less coughing, and better energy. Now, I've built my own small black soldier fly setup for protein, and I'm using fermented feeds regularly. My birds are growing faster, my eggs are bigger. I'm saving money, and I haven't used antibiotics in months. The best part? The book is easy to understand. It speaks our language, not complicated science. And it's available in English, French, Spanish, Portuguese, and Indonesian, so anyone can use it. If you're serious about poultry farming and want to move forward the smart way, scan the QR code you see on your screen or click the link in the description and the pinned comment. This book worked for me. I believe it can work for you too.
Start with the water method. Mix 1 gram of baking soda per liter of drinking water. That's about half a teaspoon per 5 liters. Do this for 2 to 3 consecutive days, especially during hot weather or when you notice reduced feed intake or watery droppings. Alternatively, you can mix it in feed. Add 1 kilo of baking soda per 1,000 kilo of feed, or 1 gram per kilo if you're mixing small quantities at home. That's roughly 1 tablespoon per 10 kilo of feed. Timing matters too. Use it during weeks 2 to 5 when growth is most intense, during heat waves, when transitioning to high protein finisher rations, when birds are panting or showing signs of stress. Always ensure clean, cool water is available. And don't mix it with strong acids like vinegar or vitamin C in the same drinker. It neutralizes their effect. Let me give you one more real case. In Machakos, a youth group rearing 400 birds used baking soda after hearing about it in a WhatsApp group. They did a side-by-side test. Half the birds got water with soda, half did not. By week 6, the soda group had 12% higher body weights, better feathering, and tighter droppings. Mortalities dropped from 6% to 2.5%. Sometimes the smallest changes bring the biggest results. Now, I know what some of you might be thinking. Won't baking soda ruin the gut flora? Isn't it only for baking? Can't too much sodium harm the birds? Great questions. Let's clarify. First, baking soda is not an antibiotic. It doesn't kill good bacteria. It creates a favorable environment for them by reducing excess acidity. Beneficial microbes thrive at stable pH levels. Second, yes, it's used in baking, but it's also widely used in commercial poultry rations globally. Major integrators like Cobb, Aviagen, and Highline include sodium bicarbonate in their breeder and broiler feed specs, especially in hot climates. Third, excess sodium can indeed be harmful. That's why you must stick to the dosage, 1 gram per liter in water or 1 gram per kilogram in feed. Never exceed 3 consecutive days unless advised by a poultry vet. As a vet, I've seen what happens when farmers overdo it. Birds may develop wet droppings or drink excessively, so respect the dosage. Also, don't use baking soda if your feed already contains sodium bicarbonate. It could result in sodium overload. Always check your feed label or ask your miller. But used wisely, baking soda is one of the cheapest tools in your poultry arsenal. It's the unsung hero behind many profitable flocks. Here's what I want you to remember from this video. First, broiler growth challenges are not always about diseases. Sometimes it's about hidden metabolic imbalances, especially pH-related ones. Second, baking soda is a powerful, safe, and affordable way to support digestion, improve water intake, and promote better weight gain when used correctly. Third, the results are real. Farmers across Kenya, from Kisumu to Meru, are using it and seeing tangible gains. And now, so can you. So what can you do today? Go to your kitchen or local shop. Buy that packet of sodium bicarbonate. Make sure it's pure, food-grade baking soda, not baking powder. Start with your next water refill. Mix the correct amount. Watch your birds closely. Keep records. Note changes in feed intake, droppings, and behavior. Then come back and tell me your results in the comments. Farming is tough, but knowledge makes it easier. You don't need magic. You need simple, proven, practical science. And that's why this channel exists, to walk with you through every step of your poultry journey. We learn together. We win together. If this helped you, hit that like button. Subscribe for weekly poultry tips and share this with a farmer who needs it. Let's build a generation of smart farmers, one flock at a time. See you in the next video, and may your next batch grow like crazy.